A horror home invasion in Sydney's southwest. A gang of eight men have stormed inside and shot a young man before fleeing the scene. Live now to Sunrise correspondent Liam Tapper, who's right there. Police believe this was a targeted attack.
Yeah, morning, Nat. They certainly do. Police believe that when these eight men came to this family home in Carnes Hill, they had one target in mind. But when they arrived, they've ended up shooting a 25-year-old relative of that man inside in the leg a number of times. Now, those eight men, they've also doused this home in petrol. They didn't ignite the fire, though, but they wanted to send a very vicious message is what they've done in the end before fleeing away in two getaway vehicles. That major manhunt now underway across southwest Sydney.
The difference between a general home invasion, if I can use those terms, is people might be coming in looking for goods. But the way we look at this home invasion, the way it's been dissected at the moment, there may be something more behind why that person or that individual had been targeted.
Now, police say this is gang-related. What level within the Sydney underworld is remained to be part of the investigation. But there's a lot of families who live in this cul-de-sac, Nat, so they're very terrified this morning that this gangland war has ended up on their doorstep.
Exactly. Imagine that happening in your street. Thank you, Liam. Here's Shervo.
Thank you, Nat. A murder investigation has been launched in Melbourne after a man was stabbed to death in the city's southeast overnight. Emergency services were called to Ashley Street in Frankston just before midnight, where they found a man with life-threatening injuries. Crews performed CPR, but he died at the scene. It's understood the victim and his attacker knew each other. Well, staying in Melbourne, where in just the past few hours there's been two early morning arson attacks on stores selling tobacco. Let's go live to Sarah Jane Bell at Hoppers Crossing in the city's southwest. Sarah Jane, these stores were just suburbs apart.
Shervo, that's right. Just a 10-minute drive apart, one sells tobacco, the other is shisha, and they were hit within an hour of each other. Police believe both attacks were targeted, but are yet to confirm whether they were connected. You can see the store behind me here in Hoppers Crossing. This was the second store hit. It was 5 o'clock this morning when offenders smashed through that front door there. You can see that they did try to set the store on fire. There's a burnt-out jerry can that has also been left behind at this shisha and grocery store. Now in Werribee, just at 10 minutes from here, there was a ram raid at 4 o'clock this morning. The offenders drove a car, reversing it into the roller door of a tobacco shop there. Again, they tried to set that store on fire but failed before taking off on foot. This morning, both lots of offenders remain on the run and police are investigating both incidents. It adds to the more than 65 tobacco stores that have been hit in the past year. Shervo.
Okay, thanks, Sarah Jane.
With more news, here's Mon.
Thanks, Nat. An investigation has been launched after two women drowned in Sydney's south. It's understood three women were swept off the rocks at Cape Solander, Kurnell in the Sutherland Shire. Two were pulled unconscious from the water and unable to be revived, while the third woman made it back to shore. Superintendent Joe McNulty spoke to Sunrise earlier.
They were down on the rock platform, walking along the rock platform, and a large wave has struck that rock platform, and the significant water pressure has pushed three of those people into the water. One female was able to be recovered.
Queensland Premier Stephen Miles is confident the state budget out today is the best ever. On top of a 50-cent public transport fares, the budget will also include a freeze on all government fees and charges like the cost of a driver's licence and hospital care. Deputy Premier Cameron Dick says it marks the beginning of the government's election campaign, but the state will also announce a $3 billion deficit for next year, the second largest since the pandemic. And the Queensland Premier Stephen Miles will join us live right here on Sunrise. That's coming up soon. A post-mortem on British TV Dr. Michael Mosley has concluded that he died of natural causes. The 67-year-old's body was discovered on the Greek island of Symi after he went missing during a walk. Investigators say the position of his body and lack of injuries indicate he became unwell, sat down and died a short time later. Unreleased CCTV reportedly shows Mosley stumbling and falling out of view on the hillside where he was later found. Well, King Charles has paid tribute to the Irish Guards ahead of the regiment's central role in trooping the colour this weekend. His Majesty presented new colours to two companies, highlighting the regiment's professionalism, courage and humour. The Princess of Wales, who is a colonel of the Irish Guards, did not attend today's ceremony. It's not yet known if she will attend Saturday's Trooping the Colour due to her ongoing cancer treatment. Well, what's in a name? Quite a lot, it turns out, if you're a wild elephant. Scientists have discovered that just like humans, African savanna elephants have their own names for each other. Now, the names are expressed in the form of low rumbles that can be heard over long distances. Researchers used AI to break down different elephant calls and then played them back to the herd. Now, video is showing that the elephants respond enthusiastically to recordings of their name specifically.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Isn't that amazing? So it's... Sorry, okay, so
what does it sound like?
It's Nat. So back to Nat and Shervo.
Oh.
That's it.
Yes, Nat is...
Wow. Where do they keep the recordings?
Sounds
in
exactly.
Their trunk?
No, they don't keep the recordings. The researchers have the recordings.
Oh, okay.
This is how they call each other. Yeah.
Did you think there was a microchip in the elephant?
I don't know, but my ears pricked up when you said that, Mon.
Do we know what the names are, Mon? What their actual names are?
What, Nat and Shervo?
No, the elephant's names.
Oh, the elephant's names. No, well, you have to transfer it. Was the first elephant that was involved in the research. The third elephant was... and I cannot pronounce the second one.
I really want to get to sport, but this is awesome.
Yeah.
I love this.
Sorry, do you want me to throw to sport?
Go for it.
OK, and now to... Barrett's.
Spot on, that was good. All right, Collingwood aren't letting an extensive injury list stop them from chasing back-to-back premierships. In front of over 84,000 on the King's birthday, the Magpies landed some mind-blowing big marks against the Demons in the 89-51 win. The win puts the Pies back inside the AFL's top eight, but they have 13 players currently on the injury list. The Bulldogs' new captain is proving to be the best buy of the season. Stephen Crichton scored two tries and set up one with a phenomenal flick pass as they beat the Eels 22-18. The Doggies are now in the NRL's top eight, but will sweat on scans for young gun Jacob Preston, who left the field with a suspected broken foot. A host of Australian swimming stars booked their spot to Paris at the Australian Olympic Swimming Trials in Brisbane. Ariane Titmus missed her own 400-metre world record by a mere 0.06 of a second. Kayleigh McEwen booked her spot in the 200-metre medley event. Australia's most decorated Olympic swimmer, Emma McKeon, won the 100 butterfly, and Sam Winnington defeated Sam Short by 0.64 of a second in the 400 freestyle as they both earned spots for Paris. Fantastic. That continues tonight as well. But our swimmers are just looking great guns.
Yeah,
fantastic.
Well.
Thank you.